channel. I'm Lisa, also known as La Dolce Lisa, and today I have a very sweet treat for you guys for Valentine's Day. I'm going to be showing you how I make my chocolate covered strawberries. Now these strawberries are always a big hit and I feel like it is the most perfect gift for Valentine's Day. So to be honest, you actually don't even need a recipe to make these. All you need are a couple simple ingredients and you can sort of do everything by eye. I'm just going to be showing you exactly what you need. So you'll just need a couple strawberries. I already washed and dried these so they are ready to go and you're going to want to keep the stems on and I'll show you why in a minute. And you'll also need some chocolate. Now the chocolate part is what I'm the most excited about because I'm going to be using milk and white chocolate. But other than that, I'm also going to be using some pink baking chocolate. These are so cute. I just picked them up at my local store. And I wanted to make them look very cute for Valentine's Day, so I thought the pink chocolate is a great addition. As well, you'll just be needing a couple mixing bowls to be putting your melted chocolate in when you're done or to be melting them with in the microwave. I'm going to be actually showing you two methods. One is the microwave method on how you can melt your chocolate, and another one is the double broiler method. So with the double broiler method, you're just going to be needing a basic boiling pot, so you're just going to want to fill it about a liter of the way up with water, and you will need this metal bowl because you're going to be putting the chocolate in and stirring it until it is nice and melted and ready to go. If that method is too confusing and complicated for you guys and you just want a quick method, the microwave method is great and they basically both work the same. As well, you're going to need a place to put these strawberries on after you dip them. So you'll just be needing a pan that can fit inside your fridge because you're going to need to refrigerate them afterwards. So you just need your basic baking pan lined with parchment paper on top so that the chocolate will not stick. You'll be needing a rubber spatula to be doing a lot of your mixing work for you. You can use some measuring cups as well if you want to know exactly how much chocolate you use. I'm going to try to measure my ingredients so I can give you guys a rough idea on how much chocolate I'm going to be using for about 20 strawberries or so. And the most important part is just Ziploc baggies. You can also use disposable piping bags if you're fancy like that, but I know that everyone has Ziploc bags in their home, so these are going to be a great addition if you want to make really pretty and cutesy designs on the chocolate covered strawberries, which are a really nice touch. And last but not least, this is optional, but baking cups, if you want to put your chocolate covered strawberries inside them after for presentation, you can lay them on a plate. If you're giving them as a gift, that would look really cute if you put them in some baking cups and handed them to someone for Valentine's Day. So let's get started. I know I'm probably talking a little too much as it is. All you basically need are chocolate and strawberries and you're good to go. So I'm going to be showing you how I melt my chocolate first using the double broiler and then using my microwave method, which is super easy. Now what you're going to do is add your chocolate to the mixing bowl and slowly heat that to a low to medium heat until the chocolate is nice and melted. Now it is okay if your chocolate is not completely melted, you can take it off the heat slightly before. You don't want any lumps in your chocolate, but it will continue to cook as you take it off the double broiler as well. You don't want this to be piping hot and bubbling over because chocolate melts very easily. So you don't need a super high heat to do that. Actually, a medium to low heat works best. And it should look a little something like this. Now I'm going to also be showing you the microwave method. The microwave method is super easy. All I do is put some chocolate, maybe like a cup or so, in a bowl that is big enough to actually fit 2 cups because you want to give it lots of space to breathe in the microwave. If you overfill your bowl while it's in the microwave, it won't cook properly. Now I might want my milk chocolate to look even lighter, so I think I'm going to be adding a little bit of white chocolate to the mix as well. Maybe I'll measure it out for you guys so I can have a better recipe here. So to about nearly a cup of milk chocolate, I'm going to be adding about 1/3 of white chocolate as well. So it's going to be a really light milky color and that should look really pretty with the pinks and the whites when it's all finished. So then when it's in the microwave, I start off with microwaving it for about 20 to 30 seconds. I keep an eye on it, I take it out, I give it a little mix, and then I pop it back in for another 20 to 30 seconds. If it looks like it's starting to melt, but it needs a couple more seconds maybe, just pop it in for another 10 seconds or so, and you should be ready to go. If it looks like there are lumps in there, don't worry because those will probably melt out. You don't want to overcook the chocolate in the microwave because that will completely ruin it. Now once your chocolate is melted, you're going to begin dipping the actual strawberries inside the chocolate and you're going to want to cover them almost completely. And this is where I said the part with your stem comes in handy because you're going to need the stem to hold on to the strawberry while it's being dipped and then you're going to place it down. So let's get started in dipping our pink chocolate first. Now what you're going to want to do is just lightly take the excess off from the side of the bowl and then place it down. This is such a cute pink color. I did about a cup of white chocolate to maybe even like, I think not even 1/3 of a cup of pink chocolate because the pink was very vibrant and I wanted it to take on a baby pink color instead of that super vibrant fuchsia pink. So I think that's a really cute color as well. If you want a more vibrant pink color, you can add more pink to white ratio. If you want it to be even paler, you can add even more white. It's just up to you really. Now I have about 20 strawberries, so I'm going to be doing a couple in each color. I think I'm gonna do a couple pink, a couple milk chocolate, and a couple white chocolate, and then we'll decorate accordingly, so it should look really cute by the end. Now that my milk chocolate has been melted with a little bit of white chocolate, I think I used about a cup of milk chocolate to 1/3 of a cup of white chocolate as well to get a very pale, milky color. Let's dip these strawberries into this beautiful milk chocolate. This looks so good. Of course, you can do this with just milk chocolate, just pink chocolate, just white chocolate, dark chocolate, anything you prefer. I just wanted to give a little bit of a variety so you can see how they look. Okay, so I just microwaved the last chocolate. This was the white chocolate. Now, this is very temperamental, especially when you're microwaving it. It might almost look like a couple seconds into it that it's not exactly finished, but once you stir and stir and stir and really stir that warm chocolate, it will melt very nicely. You'll notice that it might have started out with a couple lumps, but as I kept stirring it, they're all completely dissolved and it looks absolutely perfect right now. So it is great for dipping the last batch of my strawberries. So the final, I would say about 7 strawberries are ready to be dipped in white chocolate. So let's get dipping. Now, a good tip for when you're dipping the strawberries is actually to dip the big ones first. That way they can get most of the chocolate and the little ones will just scoop it up that much simpler. So let's dip this big one while I still have some white chocolate left. I would say even 3/4 of a cup for about 7 strawberries or so is probably the most perfect amount if you don't want to have any leftover chocolate. But if you have any leftover chocolate that you're not going to be decorating with, a good tip is to just lay them over like some almonds or something like that, or dip them in other fruits. I mean, you could even dip them in cherries, or you can definitely do more than I did. I think about 20 is great. And you also want to make sure that you pick a pan that will actually fit in the refrigerator, because like I said, these are going to need to set in the refrigerator for about 1/2 hour to 1 hour, just to let that chocolate set before you can actually start to plate them. Okay, so now all my chocolate covered strawberries are dipped and they're ready to be decorated. Now you can decorate them with dark chocolate, milk chocolate, white chocolate. What I think I'm going to do is I'm going to take this leftover pink chocolate, since I have a lot of it left, and I'm going to be mixing it with white chocolate as well to create an even paler pink color, and I think I'm just going to be decorating them all with this light pink color. I think that should look super cute and very festive for Valentine's Day. So this was the original color that I dipped it in, and I added a little bit of that to some melted white chocolate, and it came out to be this really pale, beautiful pink color that I'm going to be covering my chocolate covered strawberries in. Okay, so in order to do my drizzle, we're going to need to transfer this chocolate into this Ziploc baggie, and this is a really cool tip on how you can transfer that very easily if you have no one to help you do it. So you're going to be just taking any cup and just covering the Ziploc baggie like this and then filling your chocolate in. That is probably the easiest way I know on how you can fill a Ziploc baggie with your chocolate. So what you want to do is take your little baggie out. You'll have enough chocolate to drizzle over all these beautiful strawberries. And you don't really want to actually zip this up because sometimes the pressure makes it pop open and it can make all your chocolate spill out. So just lightly squeeze it shut, and you're going to want to cut a little opening. Now this is a very important part because you want to cut a very tiny little snippet off of it. So I think a tiny little snippet is perfect because it will make your drizzle nice and professional looking. Now keep in mind that the first few strawberries are always the worst because you're getting the hang of using this to drizzle with, but by the end, they should look very pretty. So let's just drizzle this baby pink chocolate all over. Oh, this looks so cute already. I'm just going in a typical back and forth motion just to get a light little drizzle going. And you can go over any that don't look quite perfect with just a little bit more of a drizzle. And I think you're good to go. It's so easy. It's just a quick back and forth motion that you'll easily get the hang of. Anyone can do this. And it's perfect because most people have Ziploc baggies at home, so you don't have to go looking for any piping bags or anything like that. So that's just how you take your basic chocolate covered strawberry and elevate them a little and make them look that much more professional and pretty. Now, right now in the pan, they might look like a bit of a mess because you have chocolate everywhere, which is why the parchment paper comes in handy because it is easy cleanup. So what we're going to be doing is popping these in the fridge for about 30 minutes to an hour to let them set. And once they come out, you'll lift them up from the pan and they should lift easily. Once they're set, they should just seamlessly lift off your parchment paper. And then you can plate them or you can pop them into these little baking cups that I bought that are perfect for Valentine's Day. And you could even gift them to someone in a box. Now these are best enjoyed from the fridge. I would maybe even take them out 20 to 30 minutes before serving them so that they get lightly less cool, but you want to keep them in the fridge when they're not being eaten so that they stay their most fresh. And I would say you need to gift them within a day or two of making them. Any longer than that and they won't be as great. Actually, the next day is probably what I would recommend. That way the strawberries stay nice and fresh and they don't get that soggy texture to them. So they're absolutely perfect. Usually what I would do is even eat a couple now, then I'm gonna wait and let myself plate them before. So let's put them in the fridge and I'll see you in about an hour. So I'm back about 30 to 45 minutes have passed and these chocolate covered strawberries are already set, so they look perfect. As you can see, they will just pop right off the baking sheet, yeah, without any movement required. They're so easy to pop off. If they don't pop off that easily, they're not quite set yet. If you have any excess chocolate like this, just simply break it off and you're good to go. Then you have a perfect little strawberry. So let's get these plated. And if you also would like, I can show you how they would look in these little doilies. They'll look so cute if you want to give them as a gift to someone. You can pop the doilies in this little gift box and you can pop your little strawberries in. And I think that is the cutest gift ever. But because it is not quite Valentine's Day here yet, I'm just going to plate them and show you how pretty they are. Okay, so take any serving plate that you'd like and pop them off and just plate them. I'd like to probably alternate the colors. So white, milk, and pink. And it's okay if they're not 100% perfect. It's a thought that counts, right? But we just wanna plate them up. Okay, so these are perfectly plated. So thank you guys so much for joining me. I hope you do give this recipe a try. These are the easiest things to make and I think that they'll come out beautifully. No matter how perfect or unperfect your drizzle looks, it really is the thought that counts at the end. These would cost you a fraction of the price rather than buying them in store. You can make them at home and it is just that much more special. So this is the greatest little Valentine's Day treat you can give someone. If you do use this recipe and you have Instagram and your page is open, tag me at LaDolceLisaRecipe and I would love to check out your creations as well. If you want to see me make any dessert or any particular food item as well, I'm very good at cooking Italian food, please let me know by leaving a comment down below. I would love to hear your feedback as well. So before I go, I'm just going to try a strawberry and I'm going to say bye for now and I hope you really thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. It would mean a lot to me. So let's dig in to these strawberries. I'm so excited and I have this perfect little strawberry waiting for me and it's calling my name. That is amazing. I just love it. That tartness of the strawberry and that sweetness of the chocolate is like the perfect combination. You can see that it is the perfect chocolate to strawberry ratio. This with a nice glass of champagne and you have yourself a perfect Valentine's Day dessert that was so quick and easy to make. You can make it even with just using your microwave and some chocolate and some strawberries and you're good to go. So until next time guys, I wish you a happy Valentine's Day. If you're single or if you're with someone, this is the perfect treat to make for yourself or for your loved ones. I'm gonna go share these now before I eat the whole thing by myself. Bye guys!